31, welcome to our last example. So we have a line passes through the points negative 2, negative 15, and 2, negative 3. Find the equation of a perpendicular line passing through the point 6, 4. All right, so here's my given line. And I wasn't actually given the equation of that given line, but I was given 2 points. So let me find the slope of my given line, and then that'll help me determine what the slope of a line perpendicular to that line should be. All right, so my slope here would be change in y over change in x. So we're gonna go ahead, I'll write out the formula. In this case, we're gonna have negative 3 minus a negative 15 in ratio to 2 minus a negative 2. All right, so as I'm looking at that, we look at negative 3 plus 15, that would be 12. This would be 12 over 4, that would be 3. Okay, so there's the slope of my given line, and it says find the equation of a line, of a perpendicular line passing through the point 6, 4. Well, any line perpendicular to this line would have a negative reciprocal slope, right? Because the product of these two slopes would have to be 1. So the slope I'm working with for the perpendicular lines is negative 1/3, and the point is 6, 4. So with that, I'm gonna go right into point slope form. So y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. So y minus 4 would equal negative 1/3 times x minus 6. So let's play this out. So we're gonna have y minus 4 equaling negative 1/3 x. Negative 1/3 times negative 6 is positive 2. And when I move this over, I would ultimately have negative 1/3 x plus 6. And let's just take a look. All right, my slope originally was 3, so this negative reciprocal slope does mean these two lines are perpendicular. That's great. Does this equation pass through 6, 4? Let's test it out. Negative 1/3 times 6 would be negative 2. Negative 2 plus 6 would give me 4, so this is the correct line. So there's the answer to my question. I found the equation of a line perpendicular to my given line, but it went through the point 6, 4. All right, so just to remind you where we came from or what we hope we know by the end of this section, we should be able to determine whether a line is increasing, decreasing, or constant based on its slope. We should be able to interpret slopes in a sentence as a rate of change, right? We want to be able to write and interpret equations for linear functions, graph these functions, whether that's by graphing points, graphing or using the slope and y-intercept to make your graph, or using the x and y-intercept to make your graph, and then manipulating equations of lines parallel or perpendicular to given lines. All right, so we're gonna be moving on to word problems in the next two sections. Just get ready, it's gonna be a good time. We're gonna be interpreting a lot of things, and we're gonna start to learn some statistics. All right, I'll see you in a few, gang. Bye.